the applause going, ladies and gentlemen. How are we? Good evening. Now, I don't want to sound like a school teacher, but can I make sure that everyone is seated with the mask on so we're doing exactly the right thing? It is great to be here tonight. Welcome to the Wanderers Medal 2021. I'm your host, Tim Gilbert. The Wanderers would like to acknowledge the Darug people, the traditional owners of the land on which we gather this evening, and pay our respect to their elders, both emerging past and present. As we know, it's been a roller coaster of a season, new coaches, new players, and the most goals ever scored by our men's team in an A-League season. We've seen some incredible action on the field, we really have, and the most passionate fans, as we've seen on the big screen there. We always have the most passionate fans. Now, while the season's results haven't quite reached expectations, the future of this great club is assured, and we'll continue to drive towards our goals of leading the league both on and off the park. There were moments of promise throughout the season, some debutants in our A-League and W-League teams, a trophy, of course, in the E-League, and some incredible wins in our academy teams as they continue to dominate in our youth competitions. Our second season at Bankwest Stadium, what a remarkable venue it is, world class. And this year we opened our six new fields at Wanderers Football Park, Australia's best football facility. We like to call it the Fields of Dreams, which they absolutely are. Tonight we celebrate and award the players, the volunteers, the community that represent the Western Sydney Wanderers Football Club. To begin tonight's presentation, I'd like to call on the Chief Executive Officer of the Western Sydney Wanderers, John Satsimus.
Thank you, Tim. Ladies and gentlemen and distinguished guests, thank you for attending the annual Wanderers Medal Night, a night where we reflect upon the happenings of the season that's just gone before us. On behalf of our Chairman, Paul Letterer, and fellow Board of Directors, Glenn Duncan, Jefferson Ching and Paul Perrison, I'd like to acknowledge the following. From the Parliamentary Friends of the Wanderers, Stephen Barley MP, the Member for Blacktown, Julia Finn MP, Member for Granville, Mayor Tony Bleasdale and Deputy Mayor Julie Griffiths from Blacktown City Council, Councillor Bob Dwyer from the Parramatta City Council and Lord Mayor, Councillor from Blue Mountain City Council, Brendan Christie, from our co-major partners, George Cronus, National Account Manager for Voltaren, and thank you to JD Sports as well. Senior partners, a long-standing supporter of ours, Jeremy Needham, Managing Director of Mitsubishi Electric Australia, Tina Gallagher, Director of Campaigns and Sponsorships for Transport New South Wales, Peter Hurley, General Manager of Herbalife Nutrition, Frank Majuri, good friend of ours, licensee of McDonald's, Jason Sultana, National Construction Director of Intermain, major partner of our W League team, thank you, Jason, and also acknowledge the supporters of our club in terms of Kappa, Westfield, Blacktown City Council. And for Football New South Wales, thank you for Gilbert for being here. Gilbert Lawkey is the Chairman of Football New South Wales. Ladies and gentlemen, it was an interesting year to say the least, where not only the sporting landscape, but the world in general was severely and detrimentally affected. It certainly brings to the forefront in my mind the ability to hold these functions, not only as a community, but also as a sporting organisation, and it's something that we shouldn't take for granted. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our fans, all our staff at the Western Sydney Wanderers, and the coaching and the playing staff as well. And the people in the front office who can tell you work amazingly hard. They were, I can assure you, having palpitations and conniptions in the last 24 hours as to whether this event was going to take place. But they committed to it, and thank you for supporting their belief and being here tonight. I also wish to extend a sincere thank you to our volunteers and our associations and those on our member committee who volunteer their time to be involved in the club that we all love. Also, I'd like to acknowledge the support of our wonderful club behind the scenes by our board. No better board is there in the A-League. Thank you in particular to the driver of our chairman, Paul Letterer. Thank you for your friendship as well, Chairman, who together with fellow owners, Jefferson Cheng and Glenn Duncan, have provided the club with the ability to set the footprint in the sporting landscape and the community at large that we have today in a very short period of time. While we cannot escape the fact that we had a very disappointing seasons in both the A-League and the W-League campaigns, Both teams provide the platform for our next generation of young talent to emerge and showcase their talents. Our academy program has come to the fore again, and we look forward to the young talent from Western Sydney taking the opportunity given to them with both hands and making their mark. But our club is and always has been the sum of its parts. We strive for excellence in all aspects of our organisation. And there's one element to our structure, our role in the community interaction, that forms a key cornerstone for whatever we do, and we are renowned for this. This will always remain the case. This clearly demonstrated time and time again through the work we do through the Wanderers Foundation. There are any number of diverse programs that provide benefits to certain identified sections of the community that need help, and we are there for them. To this end, I would like to genuinely thank those businesses, those councils and personal contributors who kindly have partnered with the Wanderers Foundation and provided valuable support to enable us to deliver the meaningful programs that we do. In a COVID-impacted year, we have engaged 4,100 kids through our free school clinics program, had 75 schools participate in the Wanderers Schools Cup that is taking place at that amazing facility we have, engaged over 4,000 kids in over 150 clubs through our grassroots football initiatives, held 33 club-day clinics across Western Sydney with 820 participants, hosted a staggering 1,128 training sessions and 280 games through our youth academy, all free of charge for our players with the most elite coaching development, as well as the first club to run a fee-free academy over the last 4 years for all grades. Had over 250 kids participate in our pre-academy program with 90 sessions held. Launched our own girls development program, first of its kind. This is at the vanguard of women's football. This program is the first of its kind where we had approximately 200 girls aged 14 to 17 and a squad of 35 selected, one of which is a player that comes from Coffs Harbour every week, every Wednesday for a 90-minute session. Something outstanding. We've hosted the most inspiring of programs, Nexus Soccer Solutions, run by the now legendary Ngoc Bowl, offering regular football training for 140 young Sudanese kids at our football park. Everyone knows Ngoc and the great work that he's done. We've awarded an Indigenous scholarship to a recipient at Western Sydney University and have another two recipients soon to be awarded. Funded our inspiring power wheelchair team, and for the first time, we were able to support a second reserves team to provide access for more kids to play the sport. Hosted a multitude of community events at the venue, including the Tri-Sport Tournament, Run West Festival, African Cup New South Wales Tournament, Myanmar Festival, Unity Festival, and many more. In total, we have conducted 248 activities with 254 schools and grassroots clubs and a staggering 17,512 participants or attendees in a COVID year. Next year, our plans are even greater. They include launching our five-a-side complex at Wanderers Football Park early in the new year, an expanded girls development program, working with the Darabin Lane Council to provide free holiday clinics with Indigenous communities across Western Sydney, free weekly training sessions at Caribbee Community Centre for local Indigenous community in Parramatta, inclusive school holiday and weekly training programs for kids of all abilities, walking football for people like me, over 55s, and engaging and supporting more multicultural communities across Western Sydney. Our sport is an outlet for many. We will not stop our work and will not give up. Again, thanks to the amazing partners and donors who supported our first full year, the Wanderers Foundation. These programs were in existence, but to a lesser extent previously. We thank you for your support. It's been greatly appreciated in what has been a difficult year rebounding out of COVID, and we need your further support to enable us to do more and create more impact across Western Sydney. We are indeed a community club. I thank those who have been part of our club this year and leave us and wish them the very best for the next part of their professional lives. To those who will be with us next year, embrace the need and demand for excellence, the fabric and diversity of the Western Sydney community, and always wear the badge in your apparel with pride. It may be at times a very heavy badge, but it's only because it carries a gold edition earned only through the contributors who previously have parted with blood, sweat and tears for its cause. That is who we are. It is incumbent on those who are involved with this club to always remember that. Enjoy your evening and have a good one.
Thank you very much, John Satsimus. This year saw the Wanderers, supported by the Wanderers Foundation, of course, launched the Future Wander Women program, created to find and develop the stars of tomorrow. We heard John Satsimus there refer to this. With the FIFA Women's World Cup just around the corner, we're thinking 2023, that is not far away. It is an extraordinary event, and what a bonus for Australia and New Zealand. It's fast approaching, and with interest rising in the game around the world and, of course, here in Australia, this was an opportunity to be discovered, mentored and developed as the next superstars in Western Sydney. Great initiative. The free 20-week training program started in May with 20 female participants aged between 14 and 17 years, including Alice Webster, and we heard John mention it, travelling down from Coffs Harbour every week to attend the sessions. That is some kind of sacrifice. The Future Wander Women program would not be possible without the support from ICC Development Group, ABC Radio, Intermain, and Western Sydney University. Let's take a look.
Our idea was to put a program in place that was there to improve everybody's skill level that's found their way into the Wonder Woman program. Coming up to 200 girls that came into the program, so it was numbers that we wasn't expecting. It was really good, really pleasing. Just made it very difficult for everybody involved to get that down to just the 35 that there currently is in the program, because certainly there was another 30 to 40 that could quite easily have come into it. So, there was great numbers that showed up here, and the standard was really good. Potential for these girls is that they'll go on to the next level, and the next level for them, because a lot of them are playing NPL, next level for them up is the W League. So what we're hoping for is that maybe one or two of these girls can show enough over the next maybe year, 2 years, to tug the heartstrings of W League coaches and do enough to prove that they're worth an opportunity in there.
Now, to chat a little bit more about this, I'd like to ask Coach Linda Karmas if she could come to the stage, and Libby Copas-Brown, of course, one of our players. Here we go. From the back blocks, we do not want to see an injury. We don't want to see an ACL at a presentation night. We don't want to see the Medicab come out. Yes, that always wins a race. Don't worry, I'm walking at pace and I don't go that quick. So welcome. What a wonderful initiative. Linda, what was it like to see 200 young female people ascend?
It was phenomenal just to have those numbers, but it wasn't just a matter of numbers at the trials. They were actually kids with potential and the quality to produce good football in the future.
Libby, as a current player for the Wanderers W League team, how exciting is it working to help identify the next generation, so the players of the future?
It's amazing. Like Linda said, I was blown away by the outcome. There were so many girls with actual potential, and I'm really proud to be a part of it and also learn myself.
What about the level of talent, Linda? Tell us about that.
Look, for an inaugural program and producing it at a time where there has already been some selections for clubs in the NPL, I think the football that we have seen is quality and amazing.
And Libby, you've travelled down from Newcastle to Sydney. You must be absolutely gobsmacked by the commitment from Alice. We mentioned Alice from Coffs Harbour every week. It's a long way.
Yep. Yeah, for sure. I think she's got her parents to thank for that, or whoever it is that's bringing her down. I think she should be really grateful for the opportunity that she has at such a wonderful club. And yeah, good on her for making the travel.
I've got a 13-year-old daughter who plays and loves the game. How proud are you finally, Linda, that women's football is where it is and where it's moving to in this country and around the world?
Oh, I'm very proud. I've lived and breathed football from a young kid and, growing up in Western Sydney as well. I think a program like this, a club like this, it's actually phenomenal to see, and to see where women's football is heading, it's amazing. And to, just in time for the Women's World Cup that's coming up, it's great to see.
Hugely exciting 2023. Yeah. Linda, Libby, thank you so much. Thanks for coming down. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we've already referred to the foundation a little bit tonight. We're going to talk more about the Wanderers Foundation a little later, including your opportunity to become a donor and attend an amazing event, the Wanderers Foundation Long Lunch. Now, Scotty Hudson and the team have put this together. It'll be a cracker. The Wanderers Foundation is going to keep this club at the forefront of community engagement in Australian sport. And we thank everyone that's already got involved as a donor and will into the future. See one of our staff, see Scott or Sarah or one of the team, and get involved in the Long Lunch, because it's going to be an absolute cracker. I'll tell you more about it, but I just want to plant the seed. It's time for our first award, the Westfield W League Members Player of the Year Award. This award is voted for by the incredible members of the Wanderers. And I'll open this up. The Westfield W League Members Player of the Year is Caitlin Cooper. Talent. Caitlin Cooper can't be here tonight because she's in the Matildas camp as they get ready for the Tokyo Olympics, which is just a month away, but she has sent this message.
It's a real honour to be named the Members Player of the Year. It was a challenging year for many reasons, but through it all, we always felt your support. Thank you for everything, and we hope to see you again next season.
Big round of applause. Well done to Caitlin. Now for the A-League Members Player of the Year winner. The award is also voted for by our club's wonderful members. Thank you very much. And our winner of this award tonight...
Brucey!
He's given it up! Brucey Kamau! Congratulations. Come over to... there you go. Very nice. You wouldn't see a more passionate... Come a little bit closer. The lighting. See the lighting so everyone can see. You wouldn't get a more passionate group of members, fans here. What does an award like this mean?
Yeah, definitely. Like you said, the fans here, they're fantastic. They're great. And to be awarded something like this, it's a real honour for me.
Congratulations, Bruce.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Well done to Bruce. Now, how do you say this? Oh, look, I appreciate the input. It was passionate. It was energetic. But how about we make that the last one? Because we don't want to give them all away. The drum rolls are there for a reason. But well done to Bruce. What an amazing season. And congratulations to Bruce. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to call on our chairman, Mr. Paul Lederer.
Good evening, everyone. I've got to share with you a story. I haven't got it written down. There's two things happened to me today. One, my friend, the CEO, Mr. John Setsimus, says to me, Let me go first. I say a few words. I think I've got nothing else to say. I'm done. Thanks for that. That's great. You've covered every subject there is. There's no more subjects to cover. Fantastic. The second one, my wife said to me, make sure your speech is very short and straight to the point and be quick and don't bore the people to death. I said to myself, I never listened to my wife, so I might as well talk for the next couple of hours, so that's good. Anyway, on a serious side, we are here tonight to celebrate and acknowledge our players, coaches, incredible hard-working people, and all our partners, and of course the supporters who are critical to our game, critical to our club. It hasn't been the easiest 12 months, but we shouldn't dwell on that. We're better than that. We are from Western Sydney. We represent Western Sydney. We are a tough community. Things happen. Football's unforgiving. Unforgiving. You go to Arsenal in the EPL, terrible year. You went to United the first 6 months, terrible year. You go to lots of different places in the world, these things happen. I don't like to dwell on things. I like to look at it as an opportunity to do better for the following year. By the way, our club is not only about the success of the A-League. Never been my intention or our board of directors' intention that we should make this club all about the A-League. A-League is critically important, but there's much more to this club than the A-League. From day one, when we established the club, we said we will make a difference to Western Sydney. That was our intent. That was, I think, our first board meeting, our first meeting, wherever, by the way, we didn't have furniture for the board table. We stood up and we spoke about what our club should represent. We said we want Western Sydney to be proud of us. By the way, that hasn't gone away. That is our intent. And believe me, we're working as hard as ever, probably harder, to make the Western Sydney proud of us. There's a lot to be proud of this club. Like I said, it's not only the A-League. We've got a W League. We've got an E-League. We've got all kinds of different charities we function. Sydney University. We've got hospitals, kids, Indigenous people. We support just about every charitable organisation there is. We were the first club in Australia to make our academy free of charge. The first one in Australia, by the way. So we give the opportunity to every child, to give every kid, etc. And we haven't finished yet. Let me say a few words as chairman of APL. That's my spare time job, which is a simple job. It's Australian Professional League. I don't think it's well understood that it took the better part of 50 years to get to where we are today. This is the first time that the Australian Professional League has a mandate to be separated, to be independent, and to achieve what it wants to achieve. It's a question of how good we are. We can't blame anyone else for the FA or anyone else. It is in our hands. Now, I'm pretty happy and pretty proud that we have worked for the last 5 years especially incredibly hard to get to the position where we are today. Now we have full ownership of four leagues. We have an A-League, we've got a W-League, we've got the Y-League, and we've got the E-League. All in our hands, and that's what we got. Now I'll give you some great news, and you will appreciate it hopefully next year. We signed a new broadcasting deal with Viacom Channel 10. It's a 5-year deal, $200 million involved, with an additional option for another 3 years with significantly upside, which is, I think, a game changer for the game. I really do. I think Fox has done a great job. I've got to say, I think this will be better. Bigger viewing audience, more people participation, etc. It's the first time free-to-air TV will be the home of football. It's great news. Massive improvement in the viewing audience and the media outlets. A number of media outlets and newspapers and media will be a game changer, totally different. To give you a small example of this, I think I'm not too sure if I'm correct or not, but I think I am. I think there was 4 cameras per Fox game. We're going to have 14 in this one. So Channel 10 is putting an incredible number of money behind it. And talking to Viacom out of the US, which is one of the largest media companies of the world, they are totally committed to our game. So I think it's a very significant step. There will be a new significant investor coming into our game. By the way, Channel 10 has taken a small stake in the game. It's a very small stake, but it shows intent. The stake actually is 2.5%, but it shows intent that they're committed, which is very important. The A-League, the new investor coming in, unfortunately I can't announce it yet because there are 3 separate bidders, final bidders. And they will invest a hell of a lot of money in a game because they see an upside. The same as I see an upside, the same as all of us in our board of directors, we see an upside. There's an upside. So we shouldn't be always unhappy in football, we should be happy. You know, the best is to come, let me put it that way. You see, I'm young, I've got plenty of time on my stakes, so you know, the best is to come, I'm sure about it. We have got new technology coming into the game. What's new technology? We call it Football Hub. What is Football Hub? It's the home of football digital. What is it going to cost us to build? Not much, $35 million. Are we building it? We're building as I'm standing here today. Completion date, 4 months. Start of the season, it'll be again an incredible thing. It's the same as the NBA, the same as the American Super League, the same as all the rest of the world has gone to, same as Man United and Man City. That's what we're building. And you will be quite amazed what it is. So we've got all these things happening in football that'll make our game what it should be. Because we've been talking about a game for the last 50 years that I can recall. And we always said, we're going to do it. We're going to do it. We haven't done it. But let me assure you, we will do it. Of course, as long as I'm the chairman of APL, we'll do it, I hope. But if they get rid of me, well, good luck. But that's what we're going to do. There's many definitions of success on football. Most people, let's be honest, they look at, oh, how did their team perform? I think football is a priority. Our club is a priority for to have a winning team because we have to give our fans what they want. But I think there's much more to this football club than that. Much more. None of us in a football department are happy, including our coaches. Let's be honest. I don't think our players are happy of the past 12 months' performance. We underachieved. It's very simple. We underachieved. And we've got to work harder. We've got to work harder. That's all. I've got a business career spanning the better part of 50 years. I work very hard in the past. I work very hard today, and I work very hard in the future. There's no substitute. There's no good crying. You can't go hiding. You can't whinge. You just got to get on with it and get it done. That's what we got to do. And our club represents that. I don't like talking about, we had our highs. We're the only club ever to win the Asian Championships. We won a number of plates. But that's the past. We can't dwell on that. We've got to move forward. Now, what are we going to do? We've got to make sure that we build a winning team, obviously. And we've got to support our community. Equally important. Equally important to have an African Cup and give the kids a chance, an opportunity to do something. Equally important to get all the young ladies, the girls, to come and participate free of charge. Like I said again, just to participate. It's very important for us to support hospitals. It's very important for us to support schools. It's important for us to go to McDonald's house. It's important for us to do countless number of things. That's what our club stands for. It's more than just a football club. It is football's very important. The coaches will tell you, I think I give them a hard time every time because it's important. But there's more to it than just that. Now, give you an example of our club. I'm not going to tell you the amount of money that we have invested in the club because really, I think it's quite staggering. But have we finished? No, we haven't finished. We never finish. My wife sits there, she tells you, we never finish. We just keep going. We have got 9.5 fields, two astro fields. So everyone can play, doesn't matter if it rains, shines or snows, we can play. We're going to build a five-a-side, which we're constructing now. We're building more commercial sites, which we are building. We're looking to build a hotel, which we are. By the way, this is all for the club. Every cent that's been invested in this, it's all for the club. That's what we're about. But I'm very proud of that, what we achieved. Let me say, in the 7 years, or 8 years, John, the club existence, honestly, I don't think any club could have achieved more than we have. So we got plenty to be happy about. We have achieved more than anyone has. What have we achieved? A world-class academy? I can't talk highly enough of this because you've got to go and experience it and see it and feel it. When our coaching staff first time saw the academy, they said, this is as good as anywhere in the world. You're not going to get better than this. But we're improving it. We're making it better. There's a world-class gym there. There's commercial precinct that's underpinned the club, and we're trying to underpin the club with more commercial. Which, by the way, my good friend Stephen Barley's here, and he's going to help me. So there's no pressure, Steve. Just help me. And now, most important, our staff and members, exceptional. Exceptional people. They're totally dedicated, totally committed. Totally. You only got to go out to Wonderland and see the people, the way they work, the way they behave, how proud they are proud to wear the jersey, are proud to be the brand, and the effort they put on every single day, which is just sensational. Our football department, and I'm talking about the whole department, is exceptional. Exceptional. And hopefully, we're going to get to a stage where we can look at 6-year-old kids, 8-year-old kids, to 10-year-old kids come to an academy. That's our intent. And we will give them an opportunity. And the good thing for that, of course, from my point of view, everyone gets opportunity. You can't ask for more than that. The fans we got, don't have to talk about it. You only got to look at that movie. But we've got to perform. We've got to produce, obviously. That comes with the territory. That never stops. When we put all these ingredients together, I think our club's a great club. And I don't like dwelling, I really don't, about, oh, the last 12 months you didn't have it, or the previous year didn't do this or didn't do that. No, we didn't. We didn't. I could give you 500 excuses as to why. But it's wasting your time. The bottom line is this. When you're down, you've got to get up. And you've got to fight. And our club, hopefully, is that club. Like I said, I'm very young and plenty of fight left in me yet. So let me tell you, we're going to fight. And we're going to bring this club, I promise you, back to where it should be. It'll be a number one club, as number of fans. It'll be the number one club in every respect. But I also want everyone in this Western Sydney to be proud of us. What we have done and why we're doing it is important. And that's all I can promise you. As your chairman, I promise you I'll do this. By the way, I get very highly paid in this job, so that's why I'm doing it. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Paul. Please stay because we have our Chairman's Award. The Chairman's Award is given to a member of the Western Sydney community who has shown generosity, compassion, a selfless act of ongoing commitment to a cause that supports and positively affects the region. I will get the envelope to you, Paul.
Thank you. Oh, I got it right. You gave me an easy one, didn't you? Anyway, the winner is Bernard Michel.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you very much. Bernard, stay, my friend. We need to go. Thank you very much. Big round of applause to our chairman, Paul Lederer. Come over to the magical spot. Now, Bernard, you're the president of the African Cup, which has been around for 21 years and has now found its home here at the Wanderers. Tell us about what it's been like working with the Wanderers and, of course, bringing it to life so recently.
Thank you, everyone. It's been so fantastic working with the Wanderers, a premier club, not only in Australia, but in Asia. And we are so proud and want to thank everyone here for giving us an opportunity to come to the Wanderers and show what we are. And I'm so proud of you guys. Thank you so much.
So many stories, Bernard. Come forward just a little bit for me. So many stories of the history of some of the young people that come to this country from Africa, some very, very difficult, challenging stories. This here is very much a ray of hope for a lot of them. What about the future of the Cup?
The future looks bright because as a community, we are very determined to take this competition to another level. First and foremost, the competition is to unite our people because Africa is very big. We come from different parts of Africa. Our culture is not that same, so it gives our children cultural fusion, oneness, unity, and networking, and for keep them out of mischief in the streets. And also for those who are talented, it gives them an opportunity to move to higher levels of football.
Beautifully said. Thank you, Bernard. Our chairman's winner, well done. Congratulations. Winning the Chairman's Award. Now, our next award is a very important award. It's the Rod Allen Award for Media Player of the Year. Rod was a hugely respected member of the Australian press, a dear friend of the football community. Personally, I knew him very, very well. What a lovely man he was. God rest his soul. Having worked at the Football Federation Australia and then as media manager here at the Wanderers in their foundation season. Each year on this night, we honour Rod's contribution with the Rod Allen Award for Media Player of the Year. Thank you. And wouldn't you know it, we didn't need to print too much. Bruce Kamau has won! Next awards are the Golden Boots for the top goal scorers in the Westfield W League and A League competitions. To present this award, please welcome Councillor Bob Dwyer, City of Parramatta Lord Mayor.
I would come here and get the help and the training from all the staff here that help you guys out, and it's just about taking it on, and if it's what you want to do in life, then just believe in yourself, and it's all possible.
Growing up as a footballer in the community as well, it was amazing to see players come out and to be able to give back to these communities that have been struggling sometimes with recent things. It's good to give back, just to see the smile on the kids' faces and being able to help.
Shot that one. Great video on our community and how important community is for the Wanderers. And before we announce the Golden Boots, I do want to ask the Lord Mayor, if you just give us just a quick insight into how important community is. If you come to the microphone, just important, the sense of everyone around the game, not just the superstars.
Yeah, thanks, Tim. Look, football unites everybody, and certainly as a community in the city of Parramatta. It's just something that you've got a community, you've got support, you've got everything. You've got family, it brings everybody together. And we're so proud in the city of Parramatta to have the Wanderers play, and similarly with the city of Blacktown, to have them train and have their home here. And without these people, we wouldn't be able to unite the 100 different nationalities we've got in the city of Parramatta. It's just, you know, the community, you just cannot have the words to explore what it means to us. So I'm so proud of this Wanderers team and the Wanderers club, and I thank them so much for coming to Parramatta and playing our fantastic stadium at Bankwest.
Beautifully said.
The winner tonight is Rosie Galea.
Chance here for the Wanderers, and there's the opening goal. Tipped onto the crossbar, and eventually it's turned in.
Livia Price, I think.
The Wanderers retake the lead. And it is Harry Batson down. Galea! Oh, it's four, and that is a cracker. From the right side, it slides through. Galea, three, Wanderers home. Rosie Galea looks to the heavens.
Thank you very much to the Lord Mayor, and obviously it's not Rosie, it's Kath Canooley. Kath, thank you very much for taking the award for Rosie. Couldn't be here tonight, but give us your insights to her as a player.
Yeah, Rosie's a lovely girl. She's grown up in the heart of Western Sydney. She was with us as a train-on in previous years, and to see her win this award, and you know, it really comes down to what she's about and what this club's all about. It's about hard work, determination, and having that fight. And she's stuck it out, and she's been rewarded for that this season.
You've got the big job. Looking forward to it.
Yeah, I'm really excited for the challenge. You know, I'm humbled, I'm honoured to take this role. This club means everything to me. People know I'm born and bred in Western Sydney, and I can't wait for the season to begin.
Beautiful. Thanks, Kath. And thanks for receiving the award. There are two types of people, people from Western Sydney and people that wish they were from Western Sydney. There's little question of that. Now for the A-League Golden Boot winner, I'll invite Tony Bleasdale, of course, the Mayor of Blacktown City Council, to the stage. Tony, if you could come forward, please.
Thank you, mate. I'm very excited. Are you excited?
Are you excited? That's what I thought you said. Of course we're excited. Bruce Kamau. Kamau. Whoa! Come on, put your hands together.
For the cross, body's attacking it and finding the feet of Bruce Kamau. Comes back again. Here's Kamau at the back stick. What a well-timed run that is, and what an intervention.
Aquilina, Kamau! Around one, deflection, Bruce Kamau!
Through the middle for Kamau!
Deck for Kamau, brilliant!
He's now Western Sydney Wanderers' outright leading goal scorer, Bruce Kamau. He is in some form.
Thank you very much to Tony Bleasdale. Thank you, Tony. Absolute legend, wonderful man. Bruce, it's becoming a habit.
Yeah, I'm not sure what to say, thank you.
Well, just how do you reflect on the year? Look, obviously, the team would want to have finished higher on the table. That didn't happen, but personally, the achievements of yourself?
Yeah, like you said, definitely as a team, we wanted more for ourselves this year. On a personal note, it's nice, and really, I was just enjoying my football, so that was the main important thing to me.
You might need to get a cabinet maker to build the cabinet a bit bigger because you've got a fair bit to take home in the boot. Good on you, Bruce. Well done. Congratulations. Our next award is the Wander Crew Volunteer of the Year. The Wander Crew Volunteers are an integral part of the Western Sydney Wanderers. There are currently 100 people who volunteer for the club on match days. It's extraordinary. Things don't happen without people that are prepared to give up their time. Match days, in the office, and with community events all across the Western Sydney region. The recipient of this award is voted for by the Wander Crew community. And I think the winner, I don't know what's in the envelope, but I'm sure the individual will be a very popular winner. No, it's not. This isn't Bruce. Not to say he won't win again tonight. Emma Cavalli. Well done, Emma. The magical X. Emma, first off, a little birdie told me, I sort of knew what was in the envelope, you've had an ACL problem, so you're going to possibly struggle down the stairs. How'd you manage it?
Very slowly.
You got here in one piece, which is great. Look, congratulations to you and the whole team on what you do. What made you get involved?
I've grown up around football. I've live and breathe football. Now that I can't play football, I put everything into the Western Sydney Wanderers.
What's it like being in the Wander Crew?
It's awesome. I've met friends for life, so yeah.
Can you explain what that's like? Because it's life changing for many people, isn't it? The fact that people give up their time to do it.
Yeah, definitely. I think we put a lot of effort in. I think the most rewarding thing is seeing the kids on the field because we do the mini ruse, and I think the friends for life I've really, really enjoyed.
We'll travel safely back to your seat. Well done, Emma. Congratulations to you and the whole team. Now, as you've heard tonight, the Wanderers do a fantastic job with all the community work that is conducted with the Wanderers Foundation. In its first full year in operation, the Wanderers Foundation has been able to achieve some great things, support so many amazing programs. Tonight you'll hear some wonderful stories of what football means for our community in Western Sydney, and of course the great work that the Foundation is able to do with the help of some amazing donors who are in this room tonight. We'd like to take a moment to thank each and every one of you for believing in our club and allowing us to create many wonderful initiatives, life-changing initiatives for many people and programs across the Western Sydney region. Can we get a round of applause for all of our people that are donors
Tonight we are attempting to raise a further $50,000 for the Wanderers Foundation by offering an exclusive sporting experience that you can be a part of. The Wanderers Foundation Long Lunch includes a three-hour lunch on Thursday, August 5, hosted by the wonderful people, great partner of ours, the Beatty Restaurant in Parramatta. It is just exquisite. And what about some of the special guests that will be there? Mark Bosnich, of course, legend and commentator. Carl Robinson, our A-League coach. Kenny Miller, of course, will be there, assistant coach. Western Sydney Wanderers W-League coach. We just had her on the stage. Catherine Cannulli, sports editor of the Daily Telegraph, and Australian Phil Rothfield, and NRL great 5'8", of course, Blues 5'8", Jamie Soward. Each ticket holder will also receive a $300 JD Sports gift card and a signed Wanderers A-League jersey. The cost of each ticket is $2,500. All you need to do is send an email, foundation@wswanderersfc.com.au, with your name, your business name, and contact details, or simply see Scott, Steve, Sarah tonight and get involved. It'd be great to have you involved in this. It really is fantastic what the foundation has been able to do and no doubt will be able to achieve in the future. One of the programs that really helps is a program called Nexus Soccer Solutions. Take a look.
We're just a small community. We love to fly. And the kids have been asking me all the time. They see me, like, wherever I go, I meet them, be like, when are you going to help us? We need help. We need to fly. We need a ground. What they need is just a ground and the equipment. Just for them to fly. No more than that. Africa is all about football. What we do is all about flying. Fly without the rules, just show the case and the skill. And so many talented kids here. And they're just so excited to do that in front of us in Sydney Wanderers Field.
It's a very, very proud day. We're a very community-based club, a club that wants to open up opportunities for young women, boys, girls, and for just the general public, the Western Sydney community.
This will help African community in Australia, especially Western Sydney. So see this happening and be done by Wanderers, it's mean a lot. It's so great. It's so great to see this happening here.
Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Now, Nexus Soccer Solutions was established by inaugural Wanda crew member Angok Boll. Angok has done an extraordinary job. He's got an amazing story. Who started the program to make football more accessible to grassroots participants in Western Sydney's African community. Supported by the Wanderers Foundation, the group was provided with a new home at the Wanderers Football Park, as well as coaching and playing kits and $15,000 worth of equipment and supplies to support the fantastic work Angok has been doing in the region. With 140 participants who attend weekly sessions at the park. Tonight we have Chan Yelchan and Robert Eremugo, from Nexus Soccer Solutions to come up and have a quick chat about this wonderful initiative. Thank you, gentlemen. Gentlemen, good to see you here tonight. Now, Chan, you both started training with Nexus Soccer Solutions in 2014. What does the program mean to you?
The program means a lot to me. When I was a kid myself, I've always wanted to play in facilities like this, and I never got the opportunity. But now to say that thank you to Trinitas Group and Wanderers, the support they have done. At this amazing Nexus program. It's really amazing. And to see it come to life, Angok was always talking about it when I was just a little kid, what he wanted to do with the African community and just get them going. And now it's amazing to see that it's bringing it back to life, bringing it to life. And yeah, means a lot to me and the boys, and especially the young kids over there as well.
Absolutely. Now, Robert, the program has had a massive effect on the community. Can you tell us a little bit about that? Just come forward. Tell us a little bit about the effect on the community that it's had.
The effect has been really positive, as in there's been kids that lack support, that lack a lot of things, like myself, as I never had support as a kid, and the accessibility to go to games, to find a club, so for us to be able to help the kids and make sure they don't grow up and go through the things we did is our main goal as well. And the effect is good because there's kids that are talented and we're really pushing for them to get into big clubs and for them to just seek clubs to play, you know. So we're trying to help kids so they don't like end up like us.
Yeah, beautifully said. And thank you very much to everyone involved. Well done, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a true honour to introduce this next award, the Power Chair Player of the Year. For those of you who haven't met these athletes, I encourage you to do so. It is inspiring, people playing an incredible version of the game that we all love. To present the Power Chair Player of the Year, please welcome Jeremy Needham from Mitsubishi Electric.
Good evening, everyone. It's an absolute privilege to hear so many inspiring stories tonight and to be a small part of it. The Power Chair Player of the Year for 2021, presented by Aruma, is Ben Kite.
Now, Benny, look at you. You're looking an absolute $1 million. Come over to the magic cross over here, my friend. You won this award back in 2017. You've done it again. How does it make you feel?
Pretty good. It means a few more drinks.
what's your libation of choice?
Just anything dirty, bourbon and coke, pretty much.
Look, I've had the fortune of playing against you guys. It's a fantastic sport, and all your mates are down there. Give people a little bit of an insight into the sport that you guys play and love.
Yeah, it's a great sport. I feel it's probably the best version of football in the world, to be honest. We play 4-on-4, so we have a goalkeeper and 3 outfielders. Very close to futsal, basically. Play against all the other clubs around Australia, in New South Wales. So it's really awesome sport.
Gets nice and aggressive.
It does. A few yellow cards here and there, but yeah, it's all part of football. That's why we play.
And some great initiatives. And I know that you've been a real driver of this, Benny.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I guess along with a lot of my other teammates as well, and the coaches and our team mechanic as well, Mick and Coach Logan, they've really been massive drivers for our sport. And also the support of JT and Paul and all his team at the club. Scotty Hudson, Crestwood High School represent. Just without them and all the support they give us, we wouldn't be doing what we love to do, which is play a patch of football and represent this club. I'm a very proud Bergen, love being from Western Sydney. And I don't think there's any other professional football club in the world that you see celebrate football for football. And that's whether you be an A-League player, a W-League player, a youth league player, or a parachute football player. We're just all footballers representing the one club and the one community.
Yeah, beautifully said. And there's a big tournament on the way.
Yeah, big tournament in October. So we have our national titles. So basically it's our equivalent to the A-League. So the top 9 or 10 clubs of Australia and maybe even that other country across the ditch, New Zealand, will come across, try to do something. And that's where we battle out to be the number one club in Australia, New Zealand. So that's what we want. That's what we work really, really hard for. And fingers crossed we do you guys proud.
You'll always do us proud, Benny. Great to see you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
legend, Benny Kite. Now, ladies and gentlemen, our next award is the Westfield W League Player of the Year, and it's our pleasure to welcome Jason Sultana from Intermain. Now, the Westfield W League Player of the Year winner is voted on by their peers by a 3-2-1 voting system at the end of their season. Jason, good to see you. Would you please do the honours, my friend?
Thank you. Good evening, all. The Westfield W League Player of the Year is Caitlin Cooper.
Congratulations again to Caitlin. As we mentioned, Caitlin is with the Matildas, but she has sent this video message, ladies and gentlemen.
Hi, everyone. Sorry I couldn't be there to accept this award. Firstly, I'd like to thank my teammates. I couldn't have done it without them. It's an honour to be voted by them as Player of the Year. Secondly, I'd like to thank my coaching staff. It's one of the best I've had in my career. Hope you all have a great night, and thank you once again.
Well done to Caitlin. Now, our final award of the night, ladies and gentlemen, is for the A-League Player of the Year. To present the award, could you please make welcome to the stage George Cronus from Volterran.
Good evening, everyone. The A-League Player of the Year is, surprise, surprise, Bruce Kamau.
For a lot of the young kids, they can see not just myself in the A-League and in leagues across the world, but there's also other young African boys who are making their name and applying their trade in the A-Leagues.
Thank you very much. Boy, oh boy, you've done more training than during the week. So, Bruce, who do you want to thank? A lot of people obviously go into anyone's sporting career. People make sacrifices around you. To have a night like tonight is one of those rare, rare things.
I'd like to thank, first of all, my teammates, the coach and the coaching staff, also the backroom staff as well, the fans, and also my family.
How inspirational is it to hear some of the other stories of community that we've seen here tonight and the other versions and forms of this great game?
Yeah, definitely. Like some of them said, you know, if we're able to provide opportunities for others to better themselves and not have to go through some of the struggles that we go through, then I think it's kind of our obligation, so, yeah.
What a year. Well done, Bruce.
Thank you very much.
Cheers. Bruce Kamau, ladies and gentlemen. Well, that is the awards component of the evening done. Please share your comments and snaps from the night on Facebook, Instagram, on Twitter, tag at WS Wanderers FC and use the hashtag Wanderers Medal. Please do that. Jump on your socials, your Twitter, your Facebook, your TikTok, whatever version of social media that you use. On behalf of the Western Sydney Wanderers, I'd like to congratulate all our winners, of course, both the players of the year winners and those that have helped so diligently within the Wanderers community. And as we've heard from both our CEO and our chairman, that is the beating heart of this club, is
community, and we've seen some of that great community love here tonight. I'd like to acknowledge our co-major partners, JD Sports, Voltaren, as well as senior partners, Mitsubishi Electric, Transport for New South Wales, Kappa, Herbalife Nutrition, Westfield, McDonald's, and Blacktown City Council. A party awaits you outside, ladies and gentlemen. A beautiful Western Sydney Wanderers party. We can't wait to see you all back at Wanderland for the 2021-22 season. Please don't forget to buy your ticket for the Wanderers Foundation lunch and enjoy the rest of the night. Thank you.